Hello, Hawthorne.
Hello, Hawthorne.
We learned about the different accents.
The music and the lyrics were written by Vincas Kudirka in 1898, when Lithuania was still part of the Russian Empire. How many people are there in Lithuania?
About 2,009,900, 3,023 people. How is the flag of Lithuania?
It has three stripes of different types, yellow, green and red. How is the climate in Lithuania?
The climate in Lithuania can be described as typical European continental, with warm and dry summers and fairly severe winters. Who is the president and when was she born?
She is Dalia Grybauskaitė, and she was born in 1956. What was the currency before the euro in Lithuania?
The Lithuanian litas is the currency in Lithuania until 5th January 2015, when it was replaced by the euro. How was the Lithuanian Republic made up?
After World War I, Lithuania's Act of Independence was signed on 16 February 1918. Who is the Prime Minister of Lithuania?
The Prime Minister of Lithuania is Algirda Mucevičius, the head of the Lithuanian government, and is chosen by the Lithuanian Parliament, the same as. Any other curiosity of Lithuania?
Yes, Raúl. Lithuania is the most producer of amber in the world.
Bye.
Bye.
Hi, my name is Juan José, and I'm going to talk about Lithuania history. Lithuania had a turbulent history. In 1385, the Grand Duchy formed a dynasty empire with Poland through the Union of Kremlin. After the wars, Lithuania lived under the rules of Russian Empire until the 20th century. In 1918, Lithuania was established as a democratic state. After the Second World War, Soviet Union recouped Lithuania. In 1991, Lithuania was restarted as Democratic State and joined the NATO Alliance in 2004 and formed part of Europa Union, too.
Hi, Natalia. Hi, Robert. How are you?
Fine. Hey, what did we learn about Lithuanian music?
It has a deep relation with Lithuanian culture. A good example of it is the great number of festivals that are celebrated in the country during the year.
Yeah, do you know that in the Vilnius festival thousands of musicians participated?
No, that's great. I have discovered that Mikalojus Konstantinas was the best example of Lithuanian music and art.
Did you remember Andrius Pujavis?
No, I don't.
He represented Lithuania in 2030 Eurovision edition.
Oh yeah, I remember him. But I prefer Alina Orlova. She's a Lithuanian poetry singer.
Yes, I love her song. And now let's talk about Lithuanian culture.
Lithuanian culture is a combination of Nordic culture and Christian traditions.
Oh, interesting. Also, Lithuanian culture has a deep relation with Nordic, Germanic and Slavic culture that influenced the Lithuanian culture.
Oh, that's fantastic. Did you know about typical dances? During the festival, a lot of Lithuanian people dance in the street with their traditional costumes.
Oh my god, now I see.
Vilnius is the capital and the largest city of Lithuania. It is located at the southeast of the country. Vilnius is of a great importance in terms of national media, art, fashion, research industries, technology, education and entertainment. The first written mention of the city dates from 1323, from letters of Queen Gediminas. Its historical center, one of the largest and best preserved medieval quarters of Eastern Europe, was considered as a World Heritage Site by UNESCO. Vilnius was the European Capital of Culture in 2009. Although the size of Vilnius are closely related to the history of the country, I think there are amazing sites in it that are worth seeing.
Thank you. Hello, Ruben.
Hello, Alejandra.
How are you?
Fine, and you?
Fine, too.
Okay, we have investigated about the fun and art of Lithuania. It is a place where you can enjoy its culture. Also, we have investigated about the most important writers and actors in Lithuania. For example, Minka Kudirka. He wrote the Lithuanian national anthem. And Katia Virsilas. Alejandra, can you tell me about the most important place and field of Lithuania?
Yes, of course. Lithuania has got some place where you can enjoy and now its culture. For example, Gediminas Tomas. In other hand, in the cinema of Lithuania, some actors have been nominated for Oscar Awards, for example, Los Cejas. We heard the national anthem of Lithuania and was written by Mika Kudirka in 1998. Ruben, can you tell me about the art of Lithuania?
Yes, the Lithuanian art is very colorful and popular. The most famous painters are Thomas Vaerten, and finally, Antanas Zuminavičius.
Hello,
I am Mateo, and I am going to talk about sport in Lithuania. Basketball is the most important sport in Lithuania. The Lithuanian selection always compete with the best teams in the world. They have played against big teams like Spain. It also plays such as Martínez Pozzius, who played for Real Madrid team. Another particular sport in Lithuania is fishing in the winter, when the people make holes in their ice to catch some fish.
Hello, my name is Alvaro, and I'm going to talk about Lithuanian cuisine. Lithuanian cuisine has a lot of in common with other Baltic countries, and in general, other countries. It also shares some traditions with Polish, Ukrainian, Hungarian, German, and Georgian cuisines, as well as Karasi cuisine. Some traditional Lithuanian dishes are rye bread, the traditional dish cepelinis, cold beef sauce, potato sausage, and another dishes made from potatoes, sausage, different grains, meals, and mushrooms.